wonder, my little darling, where can you be again tonight?
Elements from the Kafka story, the Metamorphoses, in a way which I hope reflects, first of all, my admiration for this work, and secondly, certain ideas which I feel the story raises. What might that be? Well, with Gregor's help, what might those be? Well, with Gregor Samson's transformation comes his realization that he is totally unacceptable to not only his own family, but to society as a whole. He is now an insect through a strange metamorphosis that has occurred overnight. There's no explanation given, it's just happened. Even Samsa can't figure it out. What has happened to me, he wonders. There doesn't appear to be any reason for it. Is it a divine punishment for sins committed or yet to be committed? Is it a bizarre twist of fate or something dark? Or is it simply the self-inflicted punishment of an overly anxious, neurotic, guilt-ridden mind, Kafka's own mind? Whatever it is, it provides a good reference point for my own work, a part homage, part personal, part social exploration into ideas of individual identities and social acceptabilities, and how, for instance, an individual might undergo seemingly metamorphic change in order to gain acceptability in society, in their own eyes or in the eyes of a divinity or in any given context, in order to avoid judgment, condemnation, alienation, being singled out, assaulted even, for whatever reason, or simply being guilty of something. The house installation provides a habitat for a part human, part insect, Kafkaesque character, who is striving to create a more acceptable version of himself, with which he can present himself to the world, to society. Hence the reason for the self-help books and the human parts constructed like strange surreal garments and placed within a wardrobe alongside a normal set of clothes. Other things in the display refer to metamorphoses. The whole is a metaphoric showcase of related objects and events. A clock monitors time, a calendar the number of days spent within the Kafka house. The house itself is also a self-contained dwelling unit and a repository of related objects. It also refers to acts of hiding, shutting oneself in, locking oneself away, shelter, things like that. I believe it conjures up images of bomb shelters and survival huts. Everything is neatly presented and compartmentalized. Everything is accounted for and listed on an inventory. Actually, one of the major influences on the layout of the Kafka house came from old photographs which I saw recently of one of the early Antarctic explorers' huts, Captain Robert Falcon Scott's base camp at the foot of Mount Erebus, a volcano near the Ross Sea in Antarctica, where he stayed was preparing for his ill-fated expedition of 1911 on foot to the South Pole. Ideas of individuality and social acceptability, I created a second character, a character called Bagman. What this is about is really, well, we've all heard the statement, throw a bag over their heads and they'd be alright. Well, I always thought this was a rather, you know, cruel and stupid statement. So this character, Bagman, he's really an ambiguous type. We can't really say he's a victim or whether he's a psychopath with a bag over his head. Through the use of incoming and outgoing mail, this creature communicates with the outside world. In fact, letters are his only real outlet. In part, this is another reference to Kafka, who throughout his life was an extremely prolific letter writer. But it is also to do with the fact that it is extremely easy to give a fictionalized account of ourselves in a letter, to falsify the facts in order to appear differently in the mind's eye of the receiver. But it's also about not always taking the written word for granted. This also refers to those self-help books, books that alongside of mainstream advertising, the media, religions, institutions, organizations, governments, family and friends, are forever trying to make us change ourselves. Of course, change is absolutely fundamental to survival, but how much do we let ourselves be transformed by other people's agendas, and are we powerless to stop much of the influences, for better or for worse? Perhaps one of the ways of curbing the less attractive manipulations of our self-images and behaviours is by monitoring the input flow of information we receive and analysing it to see, is it necessary, and are we comfortable with it?
I wonder, my little darling, where can you be again tonight while the moon is shining bright? I wonder. My heart is aching. Why for you can our love be mistaken? Darling, don't you say that this must mean our ending? I wonder. Baby, I've been through. I've been through lover's lane. I've been making life just the same. I've been traveling for miles around, trying to